What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. Hi, how are ya? Okay, now listen, we're here, we're doing this video. We're doing it. Today, we're reviewing, bam, drum roll, the Good Apple Foundation from KVD Beauty. Now, I could not believe the amount of people when I tweeted the other day, what should I review, what new products or launches is happening? Because the beauty community, it's been, my phone is going off right now. How unprofessional. But listen, the beauty community, it's been a little quiet. Where's the good launches? I'm waiting for something magical. So I asked you guys what's next, and I got an overwhelming response for this foundation. So today, we're reviewing it. Okay, so this foundation, it went viral on TikTok, I guess. I didn't see the original video. I don't even know what happened or how we got here, but after I saw everyone saying, Jeffree, review it, I logged in to Sephora. Sold out. I logged in to Ulta. Sold out. I called all the stores around me. Sold out, Jeffree. We're so sorry. Delivery's next week. Delivery's next week. And I'm like, but I want to review the foundation right now. Hello. So, it took a minute and I got 3 shades in my hand. I hope and pray that one works, but this was literally sold out everywhere. Okay, so today we are doing a Jeffree Star approved or not review. We're gonna do a wear test all day to see how this really wears. I've heard a lot of people saying that it may be really oily. Someone did an oil test here on YouTube and I guess the wax paper when you put makeup on it was like extremely crazy. But that's probably the ingredients and what is in the formula. Obviously I haven't touched it or even seen what this looks like on the skin yet except on someone else. So let's give it a whirl. Okay, so we're gonna try shade light 010 today. Now this is the Good Apple Skin Perfecting Foundation Balm. Let's just open it up right here. Now this packaging is all used from recyclable material. There is no mirror in this compact. There is no metal. There is nothing like that. It is just pure recyclable plastic, and so is the shade label, which is, I think it's cool. It looks really sleek. It's innovative. I know a lot of you are like, Jeffree, you're reviewing KVD Beauty. And I think it's time. It has been so long. We all know Kat Von D tried to cancel me a long time ago. And for some reason, she sold the shares to her brand and doesn't have any part of it anymore. And I think that is, okay, listen. Minus my previous drama with my old friend, I am so confused why a brand would continue on with the brand owner's initials and aesthetic when they don't want any part of it. Isn't that weird, you guys? I don't understand. So the other day, bam, this comment was written out by Kat Von D, and she is basically saying, I want nothing to do with this brand. I wish they would stop using my initials. I'm like, didn't they work that out in the contract? When she, I don't get it. It's so bizarre to me. It is a weird beauty anomaly, but minus all that, I know you guys don't care. Let's see the foundation. All right, now we're a little closer. And by the way, yes, I'm still healing from some fillers, so don't judge me. Oh, hi, close-up camera. Okay, so I got my notes. Let's talk about this. Now, for no mirror and nothing but just a clear compact, this foundation is $38. I was like, girl, that's crazy. I think $38 for this is a little insane. Mid-20s, absolutely. I know her brand. Sorry, not, oh my God, this is so weird. I'm not used to her not owning the brand. Sorry, this is so weird. Okay, I'm used to the brand being a nice luxury price point, but $38 for this, bitch, it better be magical. So, there's 40 shades. I think that's amazing. Now, what is this supposed to do? This is a buildable, full coverage, hydrating foundation balm with a lightweight, long wear formula with a fresh matte finish. It's creamy, it says it has an apple extract, hence the name. It's supposed to nourish the skin and hydrate. So, listen, how many foundations have I tried? Let's go, baby. So, we're gonna grab the tried and true Jeffree Star X Morphe Canceled Foundation Brush. This brush is iconic, and I'm still so proud of it. So, I am gonna, of course, do some primer. Now, we're not gonna do any wild primer. We're gonna use the primer that I first used on my very first video here on my channel, the Bobbi Brown Vitamin Enriched Face Base. I've been using this forever. It's more of like a moisturizer. It doesn't do anything magical except just keep your skin nice. So, shockingly, I have no nails, guys. Still nothing. I did break a full nail off my hand and it's growing back right now, so pray for her. All right. Now, I'm feeling really nourished. Okay. and I'm ready. So this foundation, online it says you can use it with your finger, a sponge, a brush. I keep hearing that the texture is really weird in the way it dries down. So my hands are clean. Let's just go in and let's touch it. Oh, okay. It definitely feels really creamy, a little oily. I get what people were saying online, but how is it gonna apply on the skin? Let's look. Oh, okay. Thank God the shade matches. Oh, okay. Oh, that is so weird. It feels really oily in the compact, but when it hits the skin, it like immediately dries down and it feels like almost nothing. It really feels invisible. Like, huh. Whoa. I mean, it looks really pretty. Okay, first of all, we're not doing my foundation with my hands. We've done that before on this channel where I've just taken it and gone, uh-uh. We're gonna do a beauty sponge and a brush today. So I guess, oh, a lot goes on there. Okay, I don't wanna overdo it, but here we go. Whoa. From how the texture was to how it's blending out on my skin, you guys, this is different. Like, I have tried so many stick foundations, cream foundations, every foundation in a glass bottle, plastic, anything on the planet, sprays, and I've tried foam foundation, and this texture is really unique. I like it so far. Wow, it looks really pretty on the skin. I didn't know what to expect, you guys. I'm like, okay, if she doesn't own the brand anymore, who's running it? Who comes up with the ideas? What is happening? So I don't know what's going on, but so far, so good. Now I'm gonna do one half with the brush and the other half with the sponge. Let's see if it does anything different. We all know this synthetic brush is gonna hold the product more and distribute it more, I mean. Well, the sponge is gonna actually absorb product. This is gonna deliver you a probably fuller coverage look. Okay, it looks beautiful. Let's look at the other side. Oh my God, this is the new season of The Walking Dead. And then let's go back to perfection. Ooh, even the way that it has, like, it shines, it has movement, it is a soft matte, but it isn't making my skin really dry, and I don't look dead. I am dead inside though. Okay, so we're gonna take this damp beauty sponge from June & Co. Hi, SpongeBob. You know what's funny? Should we spill some tea, Camilla, or no? Okay, I was gonna do a SpongeBob collab for Jeffree Star Cosmetics, and it fell through. Did I sign the NDA for that? We'll deal with it later. But it didn't happen, and here we are, and this sponge is iconic, actually. So we're gonna do this side with the sponge. Let's go. Oh, it coated it quick, bitch. Okay, let's bounce. Whoa, okay. I didn't know what to expect. I'm like, what the hell is this? It looked cute. But this formula is making me shook, bitch. I'm like, what in the hell? It's going on with the sponge, actually. I don't know what outside I like better. I guess we'll see when it dries. Let me just get this all up in the hairline. I can't believe I have no hair. I'm like, oh my God, I love it. Okay, don't forget the ears. Don't forget the back of the neck and blend down. Okay, now the foundation is on both sides of the face. Woo! I look like a doll. Like, what in the hell is in this? Now, a lot of people say that if you don't set it, or if you, even if you do set it throughout the day, it gets really oily. Now, I just have normal basic skin. I don't have oily combination. I don't have dry. I just have normal. So let's see what happens. I'm obviously gonna set and do a little concealer and finish off my look, but I don't think we need another layer. What do you guys think?
Looks great.
Right? And it didn't really use much in the pan at all. Like, now we can zoom in on this pan. With the brush and the sponge, I covered my full face with really barely dunking in there. Like, a little did go a long way, which is always great, especially with that hefty price point, Miss Thing. Okay, so I think it's time to pop on some concealer, some powder, and obviously with every foundation that I've ever reviewed, I always do my full face of how I would go on with the day. And then we're gonna do a wear test. What is it like outside? How does it wear in the sun, indoors, activities, and yes, dessert, tell them. And yeah, okay, so we're gonna go in with some Magic Star concealer. And let's do a little bit under these eyes. Being a CEO, sometimes you just need extra concealer. Long nights, and that's on that. All right, let's bounce. Okay, now when I put on a concealer over a new foundation, it doesn't matter what formula it is, I get a little nervous because I have mixed products before where the concealer under the eyes looks so rough, cakey, and cracked, it's a little scary. But I thought, you guys, me and Kat Von D haven't been in the same room in so long, we had to give it a whirl! So I think that Magic Star actually, all jokes aside, looks really, really, really pretty over a good apple. Like, what? Hello? It looks stunning. We're gonna also take some setting powder. I'm gonna take the La Mer, the powder, and a little JSC Magic Star Luminous and Translucent, and just lightly dust it. I don't wanna really pack my face with powder because I do wanna see how this foundation is gonna wear. So I'm just gonna take a little bit and dust them under my eyes because, bitch, I need to be set. Wow. That looks stunning. Now we're just gonna dip into a little translucent powder just in the perimeters. I can't believe it's spring. Like, it's literally spring, and in LA, it's already about to be 80 degrees this weekend. So I am shook right now. I can't believe it. So we're gonna see how the foundation wears in the heat. Okay, the foundation is on, it's lightly set, and I gotta be honest, I like it a lot. I didn't know what was gonna happen. I saw a few people put it on, it looked cool, but the texture, it really is so lightweight. Like, I'm sitting here like, it didn't really come off. So I think it's time to quickly do some bronzer, some blush, throw on some eyelashes, and let's go about the day. I have a lot of things to do, a lot of meetings, so many things are happening in my life right now, and this year is gonna be so crazy, so let's blend. Okay, now let's finish the face. Now listen, bitch, this Jaclyn Cosmetics blush and bronzer duo, girl, it's really cute, it's everything. This bronzer, it's buildable, Miss Thing. Like, I love using a big brush lately. It just gets right on the face, get in and get out. Especially with short hair. When it was blonde, you guys, I would do blush or bronzer and it would get in my hair immediately and I hated it. But her formula, listen, it's the one. Woo, easy peasy. Now, when I'm doing a quick office glam, I don't have time to sit around for an hour, you guys. So this is literally what I do. I just chisel my face, we chisel the jaw, we do our quick face, and then we get to it. Now that we're living in Zoom call world and so many things have changed in the beauty industry, we gotta always look our best. All right, bitch, we are sculpted! I love this formula, it's sickening. If you guys haven't tried it, give it a whirl. I haven't seen any new, like, really nice bronzer products on the market in a minute. And Jaclyn came back and she said, hi, I'm gonna let you guys know that I'm not going anywhere. And I love a good redemption story because she has been through so much. And just from personally knowing her for years now, I'm just so proud of her. So, bitch, you have a hit on your hands. Now, the blush in here, same. It's buildable. It's really pretty. I'm just gonna put her on there because today we're just on a soft and gentle moment. And if you ever add or put too much product on, take another brush. Just pat some translucent powder over it and just mend them all together. Cute. Come on, blush on my nose. Okay. Okay, the face is on, barely. Imagine. Good morning. Nope. Okay, so we need a quick lash and we need a quick lip and I need to get to it. So of course, hi, no surprise here that we're gonna be using Miss Fuckproof Mascara today. Miss Sold Out, Miss Ishalala Kandala, Miss Oh My God Girl. And I'm so proud of this product. I didn't know what to expect. First category in mascara, brand new, and it was a long time in the making, and I wanted to really show out and let you guys know I wasn't playing around. So if you haven't tried this yet, bitch, she's the one. The brush, the wand, they're sickening. And she's really good for a base for fake lashes as well, and this underneath for the lower lashes, it's really the one. Let's go. Okay, let's finish. All right, mascara is officially on. Now let's get some lashes on. Today we're gonna be going in with Soul Lashes. I love this style. It's in The Diva. Hi, very me. And these are really stunning. I love the length of these, and let's pop them on. All right, now let's throw on some lashes. All right, and they're on. Oh my God, these are so pretty. Usually I'd slap on a wig, but bitch, I love this haircut. So we're just gonna do a quick lip, and today we're going in with the new Gucci lip liner and an old school MAC lipstick, bitch, from the Mariah Carey collection. If you remember her, you remember her. Now, what is this shade called? This is the Gucci Crayon Contour. Oh, it's just called Nude. Got it. Okay, guys. Woo! I'm exhausted. I wish that this Gucci lip liner was a little more pigmented. It took a long time to get to where we are right now. I'm like, oh my God, bitch. We're here. Okay, let's try this Mariah Carey lipstick, Miss Thing. This shade was called MC Izzle. I mean, it's Mariah Carey. The butterfly stamp on this component, I think, is so pretty. On the actual lipstick, I mean, sorry. It's just really cute. I love a little custom moment. Now, this is in their cream sheen formula. Ooh, looking in the monitor, this is such a pretty combination. Wow, I look way too nice today. What's happening? All right, the face is almost done. I am going to go get dressed, go about my day, and we're gonna check in several times and see how the hell this foundation is wearing. So far, so good. Like, I actually can't believe how pretty it is. I think it's definitely time for old rivalries and old feelings to be gone. I don't know if people think I ever hold grudges, but shit like that, it was so long ago, honey. I'm gonna acknowledge it once. But no, makeup's makeup. I know that Kat used to be a very dear friend of mine, and how things went down years ago was really, really ugly, especially publicly. But so much time has gone by, so I always wish people the best. I do want to know though in the comments, who owns KVD Beauty? Who's running the show over there? Who's creating all these concepts? Because they may have a hit on their hands. So, will this foundation flop throughout the day? We'll see. Oh, hi guys. It's been a few hours and my friends are here to judge me. We have Lauren here who works for Jeffree Star Cosmetics. She is the creative director and we create so many amazing formulas together. And girl, are they ready for what's next?
They're not.
Okay, so back to the review. Yeah. And of course, you guys all know Boom motherfucking
What's up, guys?
So the foundation has been on for a few hours. I haven't really looked. First impressions, here we go.
Honestly.
Going first. What?
Where do we start?
Yeah. What do you mean? Oh my God, Camilla, zoom in right here.
Mm-hmm.
I've never had
all of it. Yeah.
Where?
You
I've never
all,
had foundation lines in my neck before. Look at my grandma right here.
She's dry. Yeah.
And I put primer and like hydration down there. It's a little.
It's like a little slippery.
Look at all your pores right here.
Yeah, I see them. Mm-hmm. They're right there.
You're welcome.
Whoa.
It's a little slippery for sure.
Here, touch my face and see what happens.
Wait.
Did it show up on your? I know your hands are stained.
Yeah,
we're the foundation's on top of the pigment. We're just playing in different palettes right now.
Oh my God.
It's just not staying put for me.
It's moving and under my eyes. The chin's moving.
Under your eyes, your concealer's helping.
But not the
but
best.
But not the best.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
Oh. I'm ready to go to the mall. I'm ready for my foundation check-ins. Are we rolling? You can hear me?
Yep.
Okay, we're gonna go to the mall real quick. We're gonna see what strangers think of my face.
Let's
see what people think of Miss Good Apple Foundation. My only time to get exercise is when I'm shopping. Foundation. I won't tell you what it is, but does my skin look great up, or what kind of vibe would you say?
Be honest.
You know how I look on camera normally.
Yeah, I do.
It's a little, is it greasy or no?
A little bit.
It is, huh?
On little parts.
Okay. Yeah, she's on it. Okay, so we tried to film 6 other stores. We got kicked out of everywhere. So thank you, Jennifer, for the honest review. Now, The mask probably did take a little out, yeah. Right? Or no? But if I was wearing other foundation, would it have came off as much?
No, it would just be a little tiny bit.
Okay, I look greasy, bitch. Not too much, but I mean more than normal. Like, my T-zone's wet, bitch. Come on, social distancing.
I mean, that's okay. I've seen you look better, but I mean.
Oh, what was that?
I missed the blonde hair. I'm not gonna lie.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
But yeah, your foundation looks pretty good.
It's all right, right? Or is it amazing? Does it look hideous?
Honest review.
We need a brutal.
A brutal.
Because this is my brand. So I know my foundation. When it drops, bitch, the whole world's gonna be shook.
Like 6 out of 10.
Oh. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Love
that's
that.
Good.
How would you rate yours? Like, if you're gonna wear your foundation.
My new one?
Yeah.
Probably 11 out of 10 or maybe a 12. Mm-hmm. All right, so we just showed up at Mark's house. He was in mid-work. We all know Mark, AKA Killer Merch King. No, Mark has seen me and up close and personal for so long. So give us the brutal opinion of how great or how awful I look.
Go.
And go. As the big makeup judger that I am, it seems kind of spotty here through the cheeks compared to what your complexion normally looks like.
Okay.
And your neck's kind of streaky and dotty. And it looks like when I shave, kind of.
Very accurate.
Accurate.
Boom, how do you think now that we're hours and hours in, like, it's, the foundation's been on for almost 8 hours.
It's just not settling pretty. Like, throughout the day, it started really pretty.
It did.
But it's getting weirder and weirder throughout the day.
I would call it cakey. And I don't know if that's like, to me, like, because when I look at makeup, that's kind of like how I kind of see it. It doesn't look as natural.
Oh my God. I thought I was about to fall in the pool. Imagine. Careful. Let's see if it works. The mascara will stay on, but I don't think this will. Ooh, when I touch it though, you guys.
It's lifting.
Look at my fingerprint on my nose. Mm. If anyone from the FBI needs to fingerprint me, just use my foundation. All right, y'all, we're back. It's late, I know that. It is almost midnight, and this has been on, oh girl, she's been on this face for a very long time, and it's time to give our final thoughts. Okay, so it's been a long day. Now, I see a lot of people, they're talking about this foundation. It went viral, it sold out everywhere. And I see people when they use it for a few minutes and they look fucking stunning. Now, remember when I first put it on a long time ago? I felt amazing. I couldn't believe it. I was like, oh, okay, like this foundation, it was an instant gratification. I think that's what really excited me, and I think maybe that's why I went viral. Now, 30 minutes later, an hour later, 5 hours later, and now, oh my God, over 11 hours later, and this foundation, girl, it's not it. Let's start there. It's not Jeffree Star approved.
It looks like you went snowboarding, you didn't go snowboarding.
Huh. What do you think, Camilla? Silence, got it. Okay, so.
I love my job.
Oh no, you can tell me I look ugly, hit me. I thought the packaging was cool, but at the end of the day, this is literally just a piece of plastic, right? It's cool that it's recyclable, I love that backstory, but this looks very Claire's. It's giving me very, getting a pair of earrings at icing. But overall, when I first applied it, I loved it. Like, it was a beautiful formula. It just breaks down a lot. And I set the face, you guys obviously saw, I set the face, and it's rough. I think the worst part for me is long term, it did not mix with my concealer, but around the face. And I know I was wearing a mask loosely in the mall for a few minutes, so the mask didn't ruin the foundation by any means. It was already looking rough, as you guys saw earlier, but oof. It rubbed off of my neck already, like it's gone. Those lines earlier were rough, the chin's gone, the nose is a mess, and overall, I don't love it. Short term, like if you want to film a quick reel or a TikTok, I think this is for you, honey. Instant airbrush. Now, this foundation I wouldn't recommend to wear on your wedding day. I wouldn't recommend it going to your nearest glory hole. And I'm not sure if I'm ever gonna wear it again, but it was fun. It kind of feels a little gimmicky now that this video is over, but overall, a great start. And a horrible ending. All right, you guys, so for $38, she is not it, and this video is over. So I know that there's a lot of new things coming, and I'm so excited for any new reviews that you guys want me to do, so sound off below. Yes, delicious! Sound off below, and let me know what you guys want me to review, because I and back. We have a new video team and we are really amping it up and I am so excited for 2021. So I'll see you on the next video. Bye guys.